How did I get here? In Ghana, especially among the Akans, the phrase, once upon a time, marks the beginning of a centuries-old storytelling tradition. It serves to transmit traditions, norms, and values promoting social order, as noted by Ingo. Growing up in Mpraiso in Ghana's eastern region, I was captivated by my grandmother's Anansi stories shared after sunset. These tales not only imparted morals, but also fascinated me with musical interludes and storytelling props. This imbued in me the art of storytelling and appreciation of rhythm. My initiation into filmmaking came as a prerequisite for film school admission. Nervous, yet determined, I tackled a mental health-focused narrative that garnered praise despite its challenges. My passion for storytelling fuels my journey with a goal to share our African history, culture, and heritage with the world through high-quality filmmaking. Where am I currently? Taking on the first module, Positioning Practice, has opened my eyes to a number of concepts and practices which I barely knew about or actually used but didn't understand their significance. Cinematography. Even though I knew how to point a camera to shoot and that I needed sufficient light to get sharper images, like I did in my film, The Dark Abyss with Sunlight, I have learned the importance of framing and composition to convey the necessary emotions to a given audience. I have also come to understand that the close-up shots I used without considering their implications indicated intimacy. However, there are more foundational principles in cinematography I need to learn that will enhance my future practice. As our mentor Nesta opined in A Man with a Camera, a cinematographer should first know the written rules of composition and then forget them, or at least not consciously think about them at all. For if he does, he risks eliminating all naturalness from his cinematic narrative. I also need to polish my skills in lighting, as described by Lando, as utilizing light, shadow, color, texture, and angle to provide my audience with perspective on the scenes taking place in telling my future stories. Editing, emotions, story, and rhythm distinguish one genre of film from the other. Cuts and sound play a significant role in evoking specific emotions from an audience, be it romance or horror. This is my supporting narrative for Walter Mercer's 6 key principles that inform every cut in a film, as he espouses in his writing and lectures on film editing. It is no wonder he allocates 84% to the importance of these principles of editing collectively. I believe the last 3 factors, eye trace, 2-dimensional plane of the screen, and 3-dimensional space, are like the spice to the main dish and can be disrupted to add the necessary flair and meaning to a production. Even though I was not conscious of these principles during my production, I told a story that, according to many reviewers, resonated with them and reminded them of similar experiences of mental health, and they enjoyed the flow of the story. Armed with these principles, I plan on incorporating all 6 into my practice to better engage my audience. Sound. With a melancholic song, bass chirping, and a swelling of a bicycle tire, I set the mood for the opening of my short film. I really didn't know it had a name called non-diegetic sounds. I just knew I had a way with sounds and rhythms and how to use them to bring life to a situation, in this case, film. I believe I was putting into practice what David Luiz Yerdau said in Practical Art of Motion Picture Sound. The key to a great soundtrack is its dynamics and variation. with occasional introductions of subtle, unexpected things. The feedback from my colleagues and facilitator on my project at the end of the lesson cemented my confidence when it comes to sound design. In future, motivated by Spielberg, I want to record my own original sounds to enhance my practice. Production design. To produce a film, a good production manager must bring all the technical and moving parts together to create synergy. As Jan Chapman asserts, one still has to find the story, find the money, and find the right people to work on the film, no matter the length. I agree with the assertion by Paula Wagner that it is important to get to know as much about film as possible. I've learned that it is essential to keep learning and knowing more about other jobs, as almost all film work is intertwined. To be a good producer and filmmaker, you need broad knowledge. In my previous film, I unknowingly dressed the sets with props, thinking I was simply adding signs of love to indicate the character's unfulfilled desire. Additionally, I gained insights into the significance of mood boards. It was my first attempt at creating one, and I intend to integrate this tool into my future work to effectively communicate the desired mood and aesthetics for a production. During these studies, I realized my limitations in distribution, and I'm determined to learn more about ways to source funding and strategies to expand the reach of my work, ensuring a larger audience can appreciate my creations. What are my creative interests? I agree with Paula Wagner's submission that individuals should have a clear understanding of their passions, talents, and strengths. Leveraging one's strengths not only fuels personal motivation, but also sets them apart from the crowd. This leads me to my creative pursuits. I have always aspired to become a film director. Given my diverse skill set in film practice, which encompasses writing, sound design, editing, and meticulous attention to details, along with the transferable soft skills acquired during my 14-year career in banking, such as effective communication, project management, collaborative teamwork, decisiveness, organizational aptitude, and strong leadership capabilities, I'm confident that I possess the qualities necessary to thrive as a successful movie director. Where am I going? I'm well on my way to becoming one of the film industry's finest directors. Nevertheless, I'm conscious of my weaknesses and the areas in which I need to enhance to realize this ambitious dream. My strategy involves refining my cinematography skills through dedicated practice and collaborating with experienced cinematographers. Furthermore, I intend to expand my knowledge of distribution by actively participating in film festivals and establishing connections within the filmmaking community.